What you want to do is do work that people love, like your own home. You know, if you base it sort of around, if you love your home, you know, if you can make spaces, public spaces, which people love as well, then I think that's the ideal situation, you know. I think I just liked drawing type and things at school, and then I got into St Martin's Foundation, and they, instead of doing fine art, I think they saw me more as a designer, and so I sort of went in that direction. The work I do is very personal. I like making places for people that they feel comfortable in and also that they feel like they belong in them. So I think my practice is sort of quite strange because it evolves all the time and my work has changed through, I've been working now for 20 years. I really love letters and words, and at the moment I'm completely obsessed with three-dimensional fonts and painting them on wood and in fluorescent colours. Here's another set. We've got a double one here, but... Oh yeah, so here's the words, words, words. This is a series of stools called Nonsense Stools that was part of the Words, Words, Words project at Selfridges. And I just was asked if I wanted to put something in it, and so I did a whole alphabet of stupid words. Tantalising, tasty triptych, you know. Ants ate androids. And it was fun. Studio Myerscough, when I set it up, was much more of a traditional type of studio where I employed five or six people and we worked on a project together. But as the years have gone by, I've actually sort of made Studio Myerscough much smaller, and it's just me, and I work with one or two assistants and they change every year. But then I have this other group, Super Group, where that's, I bring together a lot of people of the same experience as me, and but maybe they're an architect or maybe they're an engineer or filmmaker or something, and we come together and then we can do much bigger projects as a group, as a team. And that's how Super Group often works. And sometimes Super Group is just with Luke Morgan, who I work with a lot, and sometimes it's with five people, sometimes with two people. You know, it just depends. My relationship with the British Council has been probably now over about 15 years, and so I'd started off doing some smaller exhibitions, and then I worked on the Venice Biennale with Peter Cook from Archigram. It's called Nine Positions. We completely clad the outside of the British Pavilion, which was very exciting. The Hometime exhibition was amazing. In China, we set it up and we laid the whole space out as if you walked through a traditional British terraced house with a traditional tiled floor and a bay window. It toured for quite a while and lots of people went to see it, so I hope that that sort of got across some sort of British design way of thinking. Earlier this year, I was asked to work on a project in Burma, Myanmar, and it was really exciting because I had heard of Burma, but really didn't, you know, people weren't really allowed to go there and everything. And so this was a big opportunity for a designer to do something. We are working on refurbishing the British Council section of the British Embassy. So the British Council is in the big old colonial building of the British Embassy. They wanted somebody to come out and sort of think how their spaces could be changed and updated and responsive to the changes as well that's happening in the country. So the way I approached the project was to sit down and talk with everybody and talk about what they really wanted and how they wanted to use the space and what was wrong with the existing space. So when I came back to Britain, I then made a model and sent them the images and they said yes. When I do this, I know that it's going to come out looking like this. But if I do a SketchUp, I can't take my brain into how that really will look. So I always make physical models. And then also, I find that when you make a physical model, even if somebody isn't very visually, can't understand plans, or, you know, if you make them a model immediately, they can make a decision whether they're happy with it or not. And also for me, it's an exercise where I can work out the scale, the size of the things, and I just can put my head in there and I know that that's gonna work.